First of all, let us discuss what a square is. A square is a shape with four equal sides and four corners that are all right angles, or 90 degrees. The shape of a square can be seen in the figure shown in this slide. Let us call the side as N. We may have already known that the area of square can be calculated as side times side, or N times N. The formula can also be stated as N square. The question is how we prove the fact that the area of square is side times side. This will be discussed throughout the video. So, stay tuned and please subscribe. First, before we prove the area of square, we need to know the axioms of area. An axiom is a postulate or an assumption taken as premise. There are three axioms regarding area of surface or shape. Axiom number one. The area of unit square is defined to be one square unit. A unit square is a square with a side of one unit length, as shown in the figure. Actually, the area of a unit square can be proven using calculus, which was developed by Isaac Newton around the 17th century. On the other hand, the postulation of this axiom was developed in the era of ancient Greece. Thus, the discussion using calculus is for another day. Axiom number two. Firstly, let a surface be divided into a finite number of smaller, non-overlapping surfaces. Secondly, let the smaller surfaces cover the entire larger surface. Then, the sum of the areas of the smaller surfaces equals the area of the larger surface. This can be confirmed also from the figure shown in this slide. Axiom number three. Equal surfaces have equal areas. As can be understood from the diagram, the two rectangles shown here are the same rectangle, despite the fact that the two rectangles face different direction. Thus, the two rectangles have the same area. As can be understood from the three axiom, calculating the area of a surface is actually comparing the area of such surface with the area of unit square. This can be understood from the figure. Having understood that, let us prove the area of a square. In previous video, we discussed the proof using the pattern of number, which is the simplest way to prove the area of square. If you are interested, then please find the link to the previous video somewhere on the monitor or in the description below. In this video, we are going to discuss the proof using the duplicate ratio. The question is what the duplicate ratio is. This will be discussed in the following slide. The duplicate ratio is defined as follows. Let the values of A, B, and C such that A to B is equal to B to C. Then, A to C is the duplicate ratio of A to B. This means that A B C is equal to the square of A B B. Before we prove the area of square, firstly, we need to prove the concept of duplicate ratio. This will be conducted as follows. The premise of the duplicate ratio is shown in equation number 1. That is, A, B, B is equal to B, B, C. Let us multiply both hands of the equation by b. Then, we will get equation number 2. That is, a equal to b by c times b. Next, let us divide equation number 2 with c. Then, we will get equation number 3. That is, a by c is equal to b by c times b by c. Equation number 3 can be expressed as equation number 4. That is, a by c is equal to the square of b by c. Lastly, by applying the premise of the duplicate ratio, which is stated in equation number 1, equation number 4 can be expressed as equation number 5. And equation number 5 is the proof of the duplicate ratio. Having understood the duplicate ratio, let us prove the area of a square. First, let us consider a square whose sides are x number of unit length. This square is portrayed in the slide as the square s. Secondly, let us divide the square s into x number of equal rectangles as shown in the figure. Let us call this rectangle as rectangle R. It can be understood that inside the square s there are x number of rectangle R. Please see the figure for better understanding. Then, as can be understood from the figure, the ratio between the area of square s and the area of one rectangle R are x to 1. Let us call this ratio as the first ratio. Next, it can be understood from the figure that each rectangle R is consisted of x number of unit square. Therefore, the ratio between the area of one rectangle R and the area of one unit square are x to 1. Let us call this ratio as the second ratio. If we consider the area of square S as A, and the area of rectangle R as B, and the area of unit square as C, then it can be understood that the relation between the two ratios are actually fits the premise of the duplicate ratio, which is A per B is equal to B per C. That is, x per 1, as shown in the equation. By applying the concept of duplicate ratio, we find that A per C is the duplicate ratio of B per C, as stated in equation P. Equation P can be expressed as equation Q. That is, A is equal to the square of X times C. This means that the area of square S is equal to the square of X times the area of unit square. Please remember that X is actually the side of square S, and the area of unit square is 1. Thus, it can be understood that the area of the square is side times side. This whole process has proven the fact that the area of square is side times side. Please support us by buying our books or by donation through Patreon and PayPal. The links are provided in the description. For systematic learning, please visit our website or by reading our books. Our books can be obtained in electronic medium and as printing books. You can send the books as gifts for your beloved ones. Do not forget also to subscribe.